They didn't interrupt me this time, right, guys?
Hey, we tried. We tried.
Woo! All right, guys. 2020 sneaker and fashion wrap up right here.
What a year.
What a year.
Crazy. The fact that everybody was locked down, but there was this much that was still going on blows my mind. I mean, it's the end of the year already.
Exactly. A lot went down in lockdown.
I mean, obviously, you see a lot of sneaker news popping up in everyone's channels, but I feel like we're going to cover like everything from fashion to music to sports, just
pop
everything.
Culture, everything.
Exactly. We're going to go in chronological order from the beginning of the year, sports, music, sneakers, fashion, like you just said.
Yes, sir.
And everything that recently happened will obviously be at the end of the year.
Right.
Yeah. But I say we get right into it. All right. So starting off the list, January, RIP, Kobe, Gigi, everybody in the helicopter.
Damn.
Crazy, man.
That felt like it was just yesterday.
And five-time NBA champion, former league MVP Kobe Bryant died earlier this afternoon in Los Angeles in a helicopter crash.
Oh, yeah.
It did.
It really did.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I remember when I first heard about it, I was talking to Richie about, like, why are we feeling... I don't know. I just felt like we weren't the biggest Kobe fans, but we still felt the pain and going through the same thing.
I remember that convo. We're like, we really feel this one.
Yeah.
Like,
that's exactly the point, too, though, is that, you know, when people think of Kobe, they think of a basketball player. But then after this happened, it was like the realization of he's more than a basketball player.
He's an icon.
Yeah.
His resume. I think like the bittersweet part of this whole thing is that you really took a look at his resume throughout the years. And it's like, damn, this guy has provided more than just basketball. You know, like,
well, the mentality.
Yeah. Oh, the mama mentality is something to be used forever.
Yeah,
forever.
I remember talking to you earlier about it. You were bringing up how it didn't even feel like real to you.
Yeah, because you think of Kobe, you think of somebody who's untouchable, somebody who's like almost like God in a way. You know, he's touched the world all over. You know, it didn't feel real. It felt fake.
And
it
then as far real. As the whole merch thing, that obviously set everybody crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I feel like it had to do something also with Nipsey.
Yeah, I was going to say, not just merch, but things that just had any affiliation with Kobe, like his
you guys remember
funeral
the
brochure that the
state was
like,
on eBay.
That's the worst part of it.
That's
bro.
Insane.
That's just disrespectful.
That's disgusting, honestly.
That's like,
were they selling something?
They were selling.
It should be illegal.
Straight up.
I said it before. It should be illegal.
Unfortunate that we got to start off the video with that, but I just want to say RIP Kobe. I know a lot of people out there are huge fans of him.
For sure. It made me want to keep all my Kobe things.
Yeah.
Instead of like inflate the prices.
Exactly.
That was cool when like stores like Rift, they were like, hey, we're automatically canceling all
Nike
Kobe orders.
Nike took it off too.
That's respect. Like,
that's so, you know,
definitely
respect.
On the flip side, they did that. All right. So in February, the Travis Scott Nike SB Dunks release. And a lot of people say this is what, you know, propelled SB's back. What do you guys think?
Fire.
100%. That's the reason why it became a dunk year.
You think so?
Absolutely. Yes.
February.
Yes.
Okay.
You guys don't think it was Kylie?
Stop. The Travis Scott effect was in full effect with the SBs. Y'all saw the prices start from minimum to tripling.
I'm not going to lie. I pay attention to every SB now.
Yeah.
Whether it's hot or not, I at least got to dive into it. Like, okay, because there's a potential. This thing could be hot.
Could be hot.
You know?
This was when we went to... SneakerCon in Vancouver.
Yeah.
And they were like, what, $800-$900?
About $1,000. It was like the auction.
And we didn't think they were going to go anywhere higher.
Yes. I was like, $1,000 for these? Like, these are tight, but not $1,000. But the fact they're $16 right now.
And only
and we
climb.
Didn't know at the time this would be the spark of the SB Dunk this year. Yeah,
that's,
for sure.
That was literally the best person that you could probably get to wear an SB, man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he already did that with Jordan, but the SB just like...
And then it just steamrolled from there. It was collab after collab.
But
Nike doing projects.
Yeah, for sure. And speaking of going to SneakerCon in February, that's when we weren't even sure if people should be wearing masks, remember?
Right.
And so we had...
You were elbow bumping everybody.
We were. Hey, but it was weird to wear masks,
still
remember?
Risky.
Well, there was
still risk.
There was some of y'all that came up to us and just started like hugging right away. Like, ah!
We hit them with the... yeah, for sure.
The bodyguard move.
So speaking of that, we cannot bring that up without obviously bringing up COVID lockdown in March. What did this mean to you guys and everything going on?
It was pandemonium. It was people rushing to the grocery store, rushing to Walmart.
Toilet paper.
Hand sanitizer, you know, toilet paper. Which I didn't, which really I didn't understand. I
didn't toilet understand. Paper forks.
Hand sanitizer. Just but the dude, makes... even the dude that's capitalizing off of getting all the essential things.
Oh, yeah. It was like two people. They had like truckloads of stuff, right? Like they crossed borders, like a different state to go buy a bunch of stuff. You know, it makes me realize how unprepared American culture
wow.
is. The fact that y'all don't America have like toilet paper, like hand sanitizer.
You know, recently with my move, I had a bunch of gallon waters in my garage from the lockdown.
You thought the world was ending, huh?
What was I thinking? We have a filter water thing in our fridge.
Hey, man. It's, recommended, it's recommended to have at
it's
least
like
20
Y2K.
Gallons.
I gotta try to build a little bunker.
That's what I was like. What was I thinking? I was going to run out of water from the fridge?
To me, I think the one thing is everyone was just a little bit too overly prepared to where they obviously just took wipe everything out.
And it was.
Like, it wasn't necessary.
Wiping everything but their butts.
There's still like a max on how many like
you can get. Yeah, it's limited. Yeah, you gotta be limited.
You know, one thing I remember us doing during it was the COVID video that we did, me, you, and Tan, about like cyberbullying.
Like in the heart of it.
Yeah, well, they were like calling us out, Asians, and, you know, like we usually don't speak up for ourselves. And I think this was something where we were so highlighted. Mm-hmm. So it was finally something that we actually
like it was our
about.
Fault.
But no, that video was very important to make. And I feel like a lot of people took away something from it. And that was dope. Okay. So we also got a couple things we'll run over. Chrome Hearts, denim trend, you know, Crocs trend, KFC collab, Post Malone.
I like that.
When it comes to Crocs, let's be real, okay? They did a good job with collaborating to get like some type of recognition for the brand, but no one's getting a regular one. No one's going to the kiosk in the store.
Let me interrupt you real quickly. With COVID and everything, slides in general and the stay-at-home thing, obviously
cozy,
went crazy.
Man, cozy is in.
Easy
shout
slides.
Out to the cozy fam.
I'm telling you, I still see people wearing Crocs all the time.
I do too.
Not even
I'm
branded.
Starting to see
not even collab.
Just the basic.
We had The Last Dance in April. Remember this?
Wow.
That was literally the only sports we had at the time.
That's a good point. For sports.
Every week we were anticipating the next episode.
People suited up and wore their shoes just to watch a show
that's
in their living room.
That's so funny.
Man, I will say this. The Last Dance was the best thing to happen for the sneaker culture as far as for the youngins, for the kids that don't know nothing about Jordan
himself. That's huge.
They got a little lesson.
Didn't bring back 11, so kind of hurt me.
Not yet, Rich.
Kind of hurt me hard.
It brought back OGs, though.
Yes.
The selling of OGs. Shout out to
they
my friend.
They came out the woodworks.
Shout out to my friend Ace. He said he had like a 30% increase on all of his shoes. We're talking like $6,000 for like OG ones that are worn and beat and everything.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I bought my OG Chicago's 2 weeks before The Last Dance came out, and dude,
for how much?
Like $950.
Yeah, super.
And the dude
steal.
Was
wow.
like, I kind of felt like he probably made a mistake on it.
Exactly.
You know,
he regretted
it.
More.
Let's brush bear.
For sure. But, for sure. Yeah. Prices were actually declining before for Jordan before the whole documentary.
I mean, even the 14s, like models like the 14s and the 13s are selling out, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's crazy.
Overall, with The Last Dance, it was kind of interesting to see how everybody took it. Pippen was saying he didn't really like how he was portrayed.
Shout out to Dennis Rodman.
Rodman,
man, he's probably my favorite player now.
He did.
Oh yeah, you get to see a little wild side that surprisingly will not like. You cannot pull that now.
It don't fly now.
Well, James Harden kind of did it.
Yeah, James Harden. You know.
What else we got? We got the trading card craze, the hobby. Did this have anything to do with people staying home? You think?
That's the only reason, in my opinion. You're at home. There's nothing to do. There's no sports on. You're going to go into your old books, pick at your old cards, and feel that like that feeling
nostalgia.
Again.
Nostalgia.
You're saying everybody's just locked down. They're trying to see every corner of
their
storage.
They're going through their garage.
Now.
They're going through their old sheds. They're like, oh, these sports cards are kind of dope.
Yeah. I think it's a dope trend.
Right.
I like it. I think it's something new. And then especially with like the new Xbox and PS5 coming out, it's like nerds reunite. I love it.
Yeah.
Nerds reunite.
It's just crazy. Recently, Hypebeast reported that one Charizard card, the first edition, 10 out of 10
crazy.
Went for like six figures.
Crazy.
And then 10 years ago he got it for $700.
Damn. And speaking of people staying at home and like looking through their stuff and everything, someone was telling me remodeling your home was huge in 2020, like a huge
and organizing your home with
the
home edit
baking.
On Netflix.
Because you're home and you can realize what you
what's
don't
missing
want
and what you need.
Everybody was baking. Everybody was remodeling their houses,
yeah.
And everybody either got into fitness or they got fat. That was like, that's what I remember from just 2020 years.
That's true. That's true.
All right, so what else we got? New Balance gained a lot of popularity with the
everything
collabs.
Selling out and collabs reselling for high money.
Kawhi, what else we got? Tekashi 6ix9ine IG live stream rant, 2 million viewers.
Were you guys watching that?
I didn't watch
this. Was Hell in no. May. This was huge right after he got out. Broken IG record.
I'm not gonna lie. I mean, he does a good job. Probably number one troll of all time, man.
That's a million. That could never.
Like, I can see why the world likes to see what he's saying. Because it's not a street thing.
It was entertaining, but I'm glad for 2021.
At the end of the day,
it seems
he's
like
gone.
He's gone.
Yeah. He's gone.
Like, nobody messing with him.
It was crazy that his was 2 million viewers, and the previous record holder was Drake and Tory Lanez with only 300K.
That's the significance of ridiculous.
My question is, why does he have so many fans? Like, why do people want to tune in?
Do people just enjoy the trolls? Like it's just pure entertainment?
Troll era.
I used to think it was really entertaining.
Like,
but
you so dumb,
got,
I love watching you.
Kind of got old.
Yeah. I almost feel like people are just waiting to just see what he, like, who he attacks next. And
gotcha.
He's called out next, you know? I don't really think they're fans. I just really think they're just... They want
the
to
drama.
See that
people
fashion,
are
you know?
Nosy. That's
spectators.
What it is.
Yeah. People are nosy. That's a good thing. They just want to know, is this guy going to get capped or not? That's what I was thinking. Who's the first to cap this guy? That's what I want to know.
No one's done it.
No one's done it yet.
All right, so Dior once in June. Crazy.
Oh.
Obviously, 20K at one point for the highs.
Big bands.
Raffle system where you go
Did
pick them up and
everything. Did
anybody
think they had a chance?
No.
But I mean, when I went for the raffle, I still picked locations I could have gotten to in the event that I got it. So, like, I'm still hopeful.
Would you have flown out if you would have won?
Absolutely.
Just checking.
I would have driven because of COVID.
I remember, Richie, you were saying, like, you were happy because it felt like everybody actually had a chance.
It kind of felt like
but
it,
did
right?
Did they really like have a chance?
We know people that got them, which was crazy.
Oh, yeah, you did say that.
Like, but the production was nowhere near like a general release.
Not even
production,
close.
Right?
25,000? 25,000?
It was better than the PS5 Travis Scott's where you just get five.
That's true.
And you got to watch this whole videos. You got to watch this whole freaking video for
exactly.
no reason.
I think the Dior ones were definitely like something to shake up the sneaker world,
I think it's going to go back in time as like the Supreme Louis. And you got that Nike Dior.
Yeah.
It's like that timeline, like a timestamp.
Is it going to last, though? I feel like it's not as, like, talked about anymore.
I think
like
people have written it off.
Remember when we were saying Dior kind of came up this year and everybody in the comments were like, Dior bid hot.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
How many Dior pieces you really got?
They said the same thing about, like, New Balance or anything that we talk about.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so next topic I want to bring up is the Black Lives Matter. Protests were at its peak in June. Mm-hmm. What'd you guys think about all this going on?
Man, when you think of COVID, of all the negative aspects, this was one thing that kind of brought everybody together. It was a way to like...
Awareness,
come together, not just as people, but as you saw celebrities, you saw sports people speaking up on this inequality. Yeah. I thought it was huge.
It felt like
it's
a lot of people
thing.
Were on the same page.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think for the first time, especially with this year being like having a presidential election, it's the first time we've really seen unity in the country in a long, long time.
Yeah.
I mean, you had different nationalities and races all come together for one purpose.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And then it's a subject that's being talked about that was always brushed under the rug.
For me, I think it was really cool going off what you're saying about the unity and then the cause and everybody kind of coming together. And I felt like it was propelling really well. And just going off of that and then the riots, and it kind of got mixed in with each other.
Yeah.
Oh,
it kind of took away.
In downtown.
Yeah,
and
it was kind of like mixing up the cause, right?
Yeah,
you're not sure how to differentiate it, and then it gets blurred in. And
yeah, especially with the looters, right?
Yeah,
like the looters, when they're looting everything, like they put almost that in front of like the real mission.
It took away the real cars and everything. And I want to also talk about the NBA bubble. I thought they did a great job at
amazing
the mission and basically letting people know we care about this whole thing, not just playing ball.
Yeah.
I think that was the first time I saw NBA grab a hold of like the people and give them a word.
And took a stance.
And take a stand on something. Like that was a
big incorporating
moment.
It like on the court.
Yeah, on their jerseys.
On their jerseys.
Freedom of speech. Literally, freedom of speech, put what you want on your jersey. That was a big moment.
For sure. So speaking of that as well, the NBA bubble was in July, $190 million invested into this project, and I feel like it turned out perfectly.
It was amazing.
Like games felt real. There was no like huge compromise with the fans not being in there.
Well, they knew like if they didn't do this, they would lose even more money.
Yeah.
So they recouped $1.5 billion in revenue.
Wow.
So they just needed that money back.
I don't know how much Disney World got a cut of that. Wow. But that's, yeah. That was a smart move to collaborate with Disney World too.
I like seeing like with Miguel, JaVale McGee's like vlogs, like an insider point of view into the bubble. Did you see
the play, the player? Yeah. Some of the players had their own little
vlogs. They were like going on live and vlogging. Like, yeah.
Yeah. So I thought the NBA bubble was really cool. Did you guys hear about how they had the hotline for basically like snitching?
It's needed. I mean, that is needed, man, to keep, like, I think at one point, I think the whole duration of the bubble, there was no
zero
cases, right?
Yeah.
Because no one trying to snitch.
Well, there was also, like, a line outside of their hotel or wherever they were staying. If they crossed that line, you were quarantined.
There was a lot of rumors about bringing girls in and everything.
Oh,
but,
I bet.
I thought one of the funnier ones was LeBron's living on his own. Everybody's staying in his hotel room. LeBron got his own hotel. Yeah.
I saw that. Shout out to LeBron, Lakers. Congratulations, winning their championship. LeBron's fourth, obviously huge. A lot of people look at that bubble championship as less than others.
I saw that with like a little asterisk next to it.
And then some people look at it as even harder and greater. What do you guys think?
I think it's harder. No fans. You can't go home to see your family. You're stuck in one spot for 3 months.
It's like
a tough challenge. That's a tough challenge.
LeBron says it was the toughest.
I bet. 100%.
All right, so we have the Off-White 4s in July. Signed pair was auctioned off for $185,000 for charity, special women's release. Mm-hmm. That was really cool because that was like a sneaker we all like dreamt about coming out. And then it came out. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. They need to do that more often.
Travis Scott McDonald's collab in September.
King of collabs. The king
first
of collabs.
Since Michael Jordan in 92 to get their own meal.
Really?
Kind of their own meal.
That's a big deal since 92.
All I know is that before the Travis Scott collaboration with McDonald's, I wasn't eating McDonald's.
You lied.
That's a heavy statement.
Not as much quarter pounders as I was eating when the clap was in play.
We could pull up all the clips with you slurping down a nice little apple pie and all that.
I would have to say, the only thing I appreciated about the whole collab is that the meal was only $6.
It was affordable.
That's the only thing I appreciated about the whole collab, man. Oh, yeah. I was hoping there was a little action figure toy. I was hoping that we could get
for
the merch at the store. I don't know.
What, you want a little concert too?
I appreciate
a digital concert.
I appreciate
I
appreciated that it allowed me to step foot kind of in Travis Scott's sneakers. Not sneakers, but see what his order was.
His childhood.
Did you really care about
there was no
that?
Bacon.
Come on.
Cap. There was no bacon back in the day. You're talking to a McDonald's connoisseur here.
Man.
I've been through the stages and the phases. Don't blame me.
I appreciated it. I liked it. Yeah. I liked it. I liked the whole campaign and everything. It is estimated that he made $20 million from the deal. Crazy.
I ain't a hater, man. Well deserved.
Would you say he's the king of collaborations? PlayStation.
Yes,
right
Fortnite.
Now,
what are you talking about?
Right now,
Saint Laurent, Reese's,
hands
Hot
down.
Wheels, Nerf.
Hands
I got
down.
Another question
Why
for
is he
you.
So marketable?
Who else? I don't know, man. He's just a down to earth dude, man. He seems like he's an alien. That's why.
He's
from Astroworld.
Yeah. He's from Astroworld.
Look, when you have things like his merch that are for sale in pre-order style. And there's still a resale value after? That's
when you
crazy
know you made it.
Right. You know what I just realized? Any other celebrity that does a collab, do you notice how much they market it?
Yeah.
He doesn't even talk.
No. Nope.
He doesn't even
I don't
even
know how he sounds. Like, I've never seen it. I heard
seen
interviews.
Straight up.
I've seen an interview.
So we got Warren Lotus sued in October. Obviously, we covered this a lot. This was pretty big because it basically showed people stop copping Nikes. Mm-hmm. I feel like they used him as the example, right?
Yeah, it also helps that he was making a lot of money, too.
Yeah.
$13 million approximately from his Just the Pigeon presale.
So how much of that is he going to have to pay the lawyers?
All of it and some.
All right, whatever. So we also have in November. I was mixing December with November.
You got excited.
We got Nate Robinson and Jake Paul.
Damn.
Tyson and Jones.
Let's talk about Nate real quick, man.
What do you guys think about this?
You know, this make the Paul brothers even more cocky right now. I don't know how much.
He's good at it, though.
He's good at trolling. He's good at trolling and just, it's that, you need a troll. Right now, Tekashi, we talk about Tekashi, he gone. The new troll of the Paul brothers,
ooh,
man. They're the new trolls.
Yeah.
Like, they're good.
How
at
are
it.
You 0-1 and you get a fight with Floyd?
Money.
Broke?
Money.
That makes me, like, is he broke? Because for me, that's such, just a possible chance. Just a possible chance.
Anything can happen.
Look at it like this. If you're Floyd and you get the call, and this dude's been embarrassing. What if you're friends with Nate? He's been embarrassing your homies. Mm. Shut this dude up.
Oh, Mayweather and Nate are friends.
Yeah, they ain't that big of friends. If he wasn't helping them at camp to actually get them going, he had to go to the Hood Boxers and be like, hey, the Hood was laughing. That's all I know.
Man.
I think Floyd's laughing at this.
He became a crazy meme.
I think at the end of the day, if you're Floyd, okay? If you're Floyd, you're like, I've beaten world-class
champions
before. This is nothing. This is an easy bag. But as a person that is into boxing, they see it as like, this is disrespectful to the sport.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
So you get both those perspectives.
That's what's going to draw the views.
Exactly. Next up, we got, I'm happy about this one, LaMelo. Number 3 draft pick.
Shout out LaMelo.
It finally happened, man.
Shout out LaVar.
Yeah, shout out to LaVar,
bro. Been waiting for this day.
Shout out to LaVar,
man. He finally
man.
Got basically that, like, you know, dad figure credit that he deserves. You know what I mean? Like,
straight up.
To have three, well, kind of.
two and a half.
Two and a half, you know, sons in the NBA is insane.
He said two and a half.
I didn't mean it like that. I meant more so like he stepped foot and then he went back.
He believed in them.
What's really cool about it, man, I don't think he gets enough credit. I think he's the troll that actually used it towards a benefit of his full family's well-being.
100%.
And I, you know, as much as annoying as he was when he started and stuff, it was entertainment and he knew what he was doing to get the boys there. But I got to say, man, shout out to LaVar, man.
For sure.
He did a good job.
And he's quieted it down quite a bit.
I love when Lonzo got drafted at draft night. He was saying, I'm going to wear this hat a year from now, and it's going to say, I told you so when my other son comes in the league.
Yeah. Like
and
that.
Then at draft day when LaMelo got drafted, he had it on.
If that doesn't teach you.
He wasn't talking that night, too. He was like, my hat going to do the talking.
If that doesn't teach you that speaking things into existence and following through with consistency gets things done, I don't know what will, man. Because that was amazing to me to watch. And three sons.
LaMelo's chopping, too. He came out. He's chopping.
A lot of people are saying, though, they're only showing his highlights, his rim razors.
That's true.
Because it's LaMelo.
But he is very, very young.
They do favor him a little.
For sure. I mean, my thing with Melo was I just get so caught up in his Chino Hill days. He was a little rug rat. Just had no filter, slapping people up and everything like that.
It's dope seeing him grow up, I think, the whole time. Because you guys actually watch the show, so you guys are actually into the actual Facebook show.
Shout out to Denise.
I have no idea.
Denise.
Shout out to Denise.
Yeah, so it's kind of dope watching
Zoe.
Zoe.
All right. Woo! Okay, so this was huge right here. Jerry Lorenzo moves to Adidas.
Hello.
So I was in New York and I was visiting a lot of consignment stores. They were like, hey, we're not selling these right now. We got to see what the prices are going to be. I was like,
wow.
This was the day it was announced. Wow. The Fog ones, they were like, prices are going to go up.
I'm so happy I still got mine.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Right there. I'm happy, man.
Show them real quick.
Put them up.
One time for the one
Bam!
Time.
You heard?
Yo.
Going to it, it's just crazy that he's going to Adidas. When he posted it, it was kind of cool. He had the little three stripes on the back of his neck.
It definitely like just shifted this whole topic about Adidas versus Nike and what we've been saying for the past few
what do they
years.
Need to do?
He's like the major player that could change this whole thing, in my opinion.
I was going to say, I have never, ever been excited for any Adidas basketball shoe.
This guy 2 weeks ago was about to quit Adidas. Strand straight back there.
I heard Jerry's coming.
With him?
Of course. I'm here just part time. But
I hit you up right after.
Just enough to get the discount.
Of course.
But what are your thoughts, Brandon?
This announcement for me made me think of what's going on with Nike. You got Kanye left.
Denominator, right?
Sean Witherspoon left.
Ooh.
And Jerry.
Yeah.
Is Virgil next?
I gotta bring up something.
Something
I gotta bring up something within this. I gotta bring up something within this. Just now, Kobe and someone that I don't really know who he is, but said that he had a conversation with Kobe, and Kobe expressed to him that he was gonna leave Nike and open up his own sneaker line called Mamba.
For the players.
He didn't like the way Nike was treating his Kobe line and everything.
That could have been. Groundbreaking.
Literally,
that could have been groundbreaking.
Yeah, so speaking of Nike, maybe not. They're not
doing
something
going on in the back. I don't know. Nike's doing.
I mean, you even have like top tier designers, shoe designers from Nike even leave to go to Adidas.
Something's
going wrong with Nike, man.
Hey, I think the last final straw would be Travis Scott. If he goes over.
It's a wrap. It's a wrap.
All y'all wearing Adidas if that happens.
I'm selling all my names. I'm playing. A lot of people don't like what we're saying right now.
Going back to Jerry and Adidas, though, man, this means that he potentially could be working with Yeezy as well, too. Yes. Is there going to be
imagine
a fear of God
collab, baby? Let's get it.
That'd be crazy.
What do you think Kobe Not Kobe. What do you think Kanye thinks of this?
I bet you
like
he's
if it's a threat.
Or,
you think he feels threat? I think they're two totally different.
What they used to, I don't
they
know
were
if
buddies,
they're cool
right?
now.
Yeah.
Jerry helped Kanye design the original 750s for Adidas. Mm-hmm.
Speaking of them,
another one.
I think this is the only time I see you in Adidas in a long time.
You know, I woke up this morning. I was like,
it's time.
I'm gonna show some love to Adidas. Yeah. They might be back.
You know
I just
what?
Bought the.
They might be they back. Might. You got that speculation. You got that tingle feeling.
Speaking of creative control, all his stuff was looking the same. The Fear of God clothing,
the Air Raids from the Fear
no
of God ones.
You
know,
Jerry
them.
Would go crazier yeah. if he had yeah. the clearance. I think the Adidas clothing will be fire. I'm see a lot of nice little like praying. Tones, nice creams.
Yeah,
I want some more.
No
I
more checks
more.
Over next, boys. It sounds like it. No more checks over.
You gonna see more? You gonna see more stripes in my closet?
Wow.
I mean,
they calling it early.
I just bought the Ultra Boost 4Ds, the Ultra 4Ds.
Yeah,
fire
cream. Color cream. This was before the announcement.
Right,
the
right. Well, I look at it like this.
Y'all are going
primey. I look prime. Is that facts?
I look at it now. We got like an Avengers Civil War thing kind of going on. We got Virgil, Travis, Jordan. Who else is at Nike? The top runners.
That's about it, buddy.
Okay,
right
so
now?
Those three verses. You got Beyonce, Kanye.
Look, you might think she's hot, but Beyonce. I don't think she's up there. Come on.
This guy said Beyonce. Don't piss off the beehive.
Yeah. Watching.
Shout out to Ivy Park.
Beyonce. We got Beyonce, Sean Witherspoon, Pharrell, Kanye, and now we added Jerry Effect. Adidas coming strong.
Quality over quantity.
I said Pharrell.
Okay.
I honestly feel like I think you're onto something, Lena. I think the creative freedom. Adidas is willing to give that creative freedom to get what they need right
because
now
they're
to
desperate.
Get back over. I really believe
Well, they
that.
Need it.
They're desperate.
Yeah. We do.
They need it.
All right, so wrapping this one up, man. 2020, obviously an insane year, all right? But we made it, guys.
We did.
We made it.
We did.
Shout out to
it
2020.
It was a good year.
We grew. Everyone
did I just hear
grew.
A good year?
It could have been so
I'm
much worse. I had all this extra time working True. From home to spend time on myself,
yep.
my family, my dog. Yep. A lot of self-growth, man.
That was like a decade in 1 year for me. I like
it's
it.
Gonna be a it's gonna be a very, very dense chapter for kids to study.
All I'm saying is everybody's complaining about 2019. I can't wait for 2020. Surprise, you guys better not be complaining about
back.
2020 and be
yeah.
grateful for 2021 to come now.
Right. 2021, yeah. Shout out
yes,
to you guys, House of Hype. We
yeah,
definitely
man.
Did our thing
that was fun.
In 2020. R.I.P. Pop Smoke,
for sure.
King Von,
Chad Boseman.
Oh, Chadwick
yeah.
Boseman.
Yeah, yeah. Black Panther.
Conda.
You know, that's one of the
Black
another
Panther,
celebrity
man.
That passed away that really brought unity to everybody
Very
because
true.
You
time.
Learned so much from him internally, so mentally.
Especially too with the whole like looking a certain way way in photos and the people
yes.
were trying to
people
clown.
People were trolling
yep.
him for
yeah.
losing
was,
all that weight
he
when
was
you're
sick,
going through chemo.
Just announce
yeah,
it.
Mm-hmm. Just yep. how he went out.
Yeah,
yeah
for
didn't
sure.
want no one to worry about him.
Yeah,
yeah
was that was definitely very admirable.
Yep.
So yeah, 2020 though. Let us know what you guys think. Shout out to you guys for supporting the whole channel and everything. Everybody kind of, you know, basically like became fans of everybody, I would say. Like,
oh, yeah.
Everybody
Ooh,
has
yeah.
their, you know.
They didn't interrupt me this time, right, guys?
Hey, we tried. We tried.
Speak up, little lady. That's all I'm going to say.
That was crazy.
Equality. Speak up.
You guys have been showing me so much love. Thank you.
We're going
to hair going.
Wow.
Speak up.
You know what it is? You know what it
is?
It's a bunch of simps.
Simp. All right, simp, simp.
All right, guys. Man, that was a crazy wrap up.
Yeah.
Shout out to you guys. Make sure you guys share this with your friends. The ultimate 2020 wrap up.
I love it.
The best on YouTube.
Yeah.
All right. Peace.